Well, today we're digging into spintronic tunneling with Daniella at NVE. So, Dano, what is tunneling and how does it work?
Tunneling is a nanoscale phenomenon where, under the right conditions, electrons can tunnel through very thin, normally insulating materials, causing lower resistance. Structures are called magnetic tunnel junctions or tunneling magnetoresistors. Let's look at one. The section on the right is called the free layer because its electron spins are free to change, and the layer on the left is the pinned or reference layer because its spin orientation is fixed when the device is made. The barrier between the pinned and free layers is thin enough that electrons can tunnel through, as the meter shows, because of the scattering caused by electrons spinning in opposite directions. The tunnel barrier is close to its insulating state. When a field is applied, the free layer polarization switches, electrons can tunnel, and the resistance is low, even though this is a normally insulating material. In this way, we can turn the esoteric property of electron spin into something useful: resistance. The resistance change can be very large. Large signals can mean smaller size, more precision, and lower power spintronic devices. Here's an SEM of an actual tunnel junction made here at NVE. This white stripe is an aluminum oxide tunnel barrier, 8 atoms thick. This is probably magnified nearly a million times on your screen, so an 8-inch wafer would appear 100 miles in diameter.
Cool. How can our viewers burrow into this?
You can go to nve.com for lots more info.